Hello everybody, this is Jonathan, and today I'll be showing you guys how to install the OpenIndia operating system. So this is a basically a Unix-like operating system that was meant to replace SunOS. I can read a bit about it. So Sun ecosystem, SunOS, which evolved into the rechristened Solaris, began as a proprietary Unix distribution designed to support Sun's Spark processors. Its list of supported hardware widened at its grew. And in 2005, Sun released the source code in the form of OpenSolaris, leading to the advanced community development, and the Ocular purchased Sun. Renamed the OS once more to Ocular Solaris and decided to create source releases, effectively closing the source once again. Sometime after this movement, the community took it upon themselves to maintain OpenSUSE Solaris. They decided to ditch its development tools and processes and created the Open Indiana Hipster branch to modernize the OS. Hipster is compiled to GCC instead of Sun Studio and follows a running release model, and the release team puts out installable snapshots to every 6 months. What makes OpenDROI approachable to new users is that it runs familiar apps on the desktop. It uses a Mate desktop along with its cache of tools, as well as handful of mainstream productivity apps such as Firefox, Thunderbird, and Penguin. While there is not much to write home about OI's default cache of apps, one that caught our eye was the TimeSlide app for taking incremental CFS file system snapshots. It isn't enabled by default, but it's fairly intuitive to set up and use. So in simple terms, the OpenIndia is meant to replace SunOS and is meant to make it look more modern and act more modern. And it uses the Mate desktop environment and has many softwares that you guys probably would have used before. So to install it, just go down this website, which I've left down in the description, and go to the downloads and just select this one, and that's how you'll be able to install it. But I already have it installed in, already have set up my photo machine, so all I need to do is open it up and I should be able to boot up to it. Now all I need to do to install the operating system is to click onto one so we can boot up to it. It looks quite similar to FreeBSD, that is correct, but it's completely a different operating system. Now from here we can select which language you want to use. So there's Arabic, there's Chinese, there's Dutch, and there's Russian. There is also Polish, there's also Japanese. Just select a language that you guys speak and understand, basically. Don't worry about these warnings, they're not really that critical. Okay. And yes, it opens up very quickly. And as you guys can see, it does use a Mate desktop environment. I'm going to just close out these pop-ups. But we can install it two ways. You can install it through a graphical user interface, or we can install it through a text installer. But as I want to keep this video simple, I'll go through the graphical user interface installer. So all you do is double tap on it, and then from here, click onto the next button once you finish with this instructions or finish reading stuff. So over here it says, thanks for choosing to install OpenIndia OS. Before we start, review for release notes for this release. For a list of known problems or detailed step-by-step procedures for complete disinstallation, select the Getting Started with OpenIndia icon on the Live CD desktop. This installer will not upgrade existing installations of OpenIndia. If you would like to upgrade or an existing installation, select the Getting Started with OpenIndia icon on the Live CD desktop and review for upgrade instructions in the document. So all you guys need to do next is just click onto next. Now you guys should be able to start partitioning it, so you guys can start to partition the disk, and you guys can just be able to select the partition type and then how big you want that partition to be. But I'm going to just click on to use the whole disk, which will just erase the entire drive, but I have nothing on it, so I'm just going to click onto next. Now over here we can select to time zone. I'm right now in United Kingdom, so I'm just going to select this one. That seems fine. Everything should be automatically set up, right? So if I click onto Africa, yep. And I'm going to click back onto here, and the time should basically be the same, really. And it does seem like it is the same. That's amazing. But you guys can select where we're from. If we're from America, then you just select America. We can select Denver. So these have different time zones. But England only has like one time zone, whereas in the United States it has like 2 billion time zones. So just select which time zone is yours. And if you don't know, just search up on Google. But we should know what is the time zone in your country is, or what state you're in. Or because Russia is a big country, they have like many time zones there, so just make sure we select the right time zone so that we know what time is. Now click on to next, and now from here you guys can select which language you want. So just click on to England, English, territory. I don't know why they have that here. I thought we already selected that we wanted to select which location we're in, which country, but I guess I'll leave it as United States. There's no England on. Wait, Britain again. That one is fine. Now click on to next, and now we can set up for user password for the system, as well as creating a new user. So I'm going to select my password first. I'm going to keep it as a simple password. Your real name, Jonathan, and now we can do a login name required when creating a user. Select John. User password, I'm going to select as being the same. Confirm password. Computer name, I like this, so that's pretty nice. So we can create our own user, we can create a password, a root password as well. Now click on to next, and now as you guys can see, we can review for settings, we can see what time zone we're in, which location we're in, what user is going to be, and so on, and what the computer name is, and all that. So that's a very nice brief, and the way it's displayed is very nicely, because it actually confirms if this is all correct. So it has stuff categorized. So we have disk. This disk could be erased, so that's a warning. And over there shows up for software that will be installed, which is this operating system. And I also got the time zone, and I also got the locale, and they got users and all that. So I'm going to click on to install, and now it should start installing for system to a hard drive or to a solid state drive. So it shouldn't take long to do. It seems like a very small operating system. So yeah. So basically it has finished installing. We can read its installation log if we truly wanted to, but all you need to do now is click onto the reboot button, and that should reboot the computer and should allow you to boot up to the system. Yeah, like so. Okay, let me go into privileges. I'll go into the devices, right? Let me remove the ISO image so I don't boot up to it. Let me close out that. Let me reopen the operating system, and hopefully it was able to install the hard drive successfully. Looks like it was able to boot up successfully. So it looks like everything is working fine. Booting. Everything is looking great. By the way, guys, if you're wondering, is this Linux? It's not Linux. It's not Linux at all. So what works on Linux may not work for Open Indiana, for example, because they're both at different operating systems. So yeah. Okay, so from here we can enter your username and your password, which I think was John. And the password, I know what that is, it's a very simple one. Am I booting up? Looks like I was able to boot up. That is amazing. Now going to system, what I want to do is to be able to change the change the display because it's not correctly showing up everything on the screen. As you guys can see, when I scroll way down, I just see that section. So I just want to change it if I can. Collection. System, purposes, right? Hardware, displays. Okay, so we can change the resolution. How does that one look? Okay, that one looks a lot better. Keep this configuration, so now we can see everything's fit in fine within the desktop. That is amazing. Now click onto the close button, and this is how you guys be able to change display by going to system, purposes, hardware, displays, and just select which resolution you want, and just close out of it once you have selected it, and everything should be fine. Select displays, select which resolution you want, click onto apply, close out of it. It's as simple as that. And we were able to install it successfully using a graphical user interface. If you guys like this video, please put a like and please subscribe, and I will see you guys next time. Bye bye.